Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of creatnprocess. In today's video, we'll look at how you can create 3D retro text effect in Adobe Illustrator. We'll be creating out these three designs one by one. First of all, we'll create out this star text, which is a 3D retro effect where we have used the blending options to create the depth, and we have added the shadow using the drop shadow effect. And later we have added some thickness with a stroke and shades to give some depth. In the second design, we'll be using 3D extrude bevel option to create out this design. So we'll be adding this depth using 3D bevel option. Then for the shades, we'll be using the blending option to create this hard falling shades. And later on, we'll work on with this outlines using the offset option. Then we'll add some shades and all. And for the last design, we'll be using the same technique to create this basic shape with the blending option. And after that, we'll be adding like shades using the patterns. And we'll understand how we can use patterns to give like details to your design. And later on the front as well, we'll use the parallel line patterns and we'll add some shades like this. So we'll be creating these three designs in this tutorial. If you haven't checked out our previous tutorial, in our first part of our design, we have created this sketchy retro design and we have created a vintage and then a block text. Later, we have seen how you can create these designs. We had the tutorial is very in-depth, so check out if you haven't seen it yet. I'll be sharing the link in the description. So let's begin with the designing process of this tutorial. So first of all, let's understand how we can create this design. So we'll start from the basic. So the basic thing is, let's type out our text. So I'll type out my text str, and let's scale up the font. So command control t, and let's scale it up. Here's our text. So the text which I'm using over here is a leg hug. You can find it, or if you don't have it, you can download it. It's the name leg hug. I'm using the simple font like this. And let's reduce the spacing between each of the alphabets. So I'll go to character and let's reduce it to 0 maybe, or we need some gap, so let's add accordingly. So let's try about 100 and let's check it out. And I think, yeah, this is good. So I'll increase the scale with the Alt and Shift pressed. Just click and drag, and you can scale it from the center without distorting the shape. So around this much. So after scaling the text, let's convert this into outlines. So the first step is to convert text into outline shapes. Now let's begin. So first of all, I'll add this base color. So let's create that out. So with the eyedropper, I'll pick this color and I'll show you the color code as well. So double click on this and this is the color code. So this is a light little sand, like a sand color, and this is the color code. So you can use that color code and you'll get the same color. Now to we'll add this depth. So to create this depth, we'll use the blending option. So first I'll select this and create a duplicate of it. But before, I'll create a copy, command or control C to copy like that. And now I'll create a duplicate with the Alt press. Just click and drag it down and see how much thickness you want to give to your design. So I'll keep it around maybe this much, and we can adjust later on as well, so you don't need to worry. So I select both of them and we'll go to object, blend, and blend options. So on the blend options, you have to decide how much blending steps you want to give. So I have chosen blending steps and I have given around 200. You can give any much amount you want, so it depends on your document size. If you give 20, then you see those steps. We want a smooth line over here when it's a blend, so I'm giving around 200 just to make sure everything is smooth. So again, go to object and go to blend and click on make, and this will blend that in a very smooth way. Now let's change the color. So I'll pick this, and with the eyedropper I'll pick this color. So this is like a faded brown color, dark one. So I'll just double click on it and you can see the color code over here. So the color is around here and this is the 423802 color code. So this is the color code I have given. Now let's arrange it to back. So with the command or control pressed, click the open square bracket and it will arrange it to our main text. And here we go. We have done our first step. We have added a simple depth to it. Now we'll work on the this upper shadow, upper depth. So we'll be creating those details. So to create that, I'll just create one duplicate of this. Command Control C or Command Control F to create a duplicate on top. And now we'll change the top to like stroke and remove the fill color. And for the stroke, let's change the color to white and click OK. Now, first of all, we have to make sure the text are inside. So I'll go to stroke and make it inside. So align stroke to inside and it will be inside our text. And now we have given around 1 pixel thickness for this. So it's depend on your document size. For my design, 1 pixel is good enough. So I'm keeping it like that way. So we have added that nice border. Now let's create this drop shadow effect over here inside one. So to create that, what I will do is we'll create a duplicate of this one more time. So I'll paste a copy of it, Command or Control F, paste one more time this way, and with the Alt press, I'll create a duplicate and drag it down. So just like this, and let's decide how much thickness you want to give. So we'll keep it around, let's say this much. So I'll leave it like this. Now, what we'll do is we'll be using these. This is our main, and we'll be using this one, top one, to subtract it from the main. So we cannot subtract it directly because all of them are like separate objects. So if I go to Pathfinder and if you click on subtract, it wouldn't happen. So what we need to do is we need to convert them into compound fill object. So first of all, I'll select this one, ungroup it, and go to object, compound path, and make. In the same way, select the other one, right click, ungroup, then go to object, compound path, and make. And this way, now if you select both of them and go to Pathfinder, and you can just click on minus front, it will subtract top shape. And now I'll fill this up with some color. So with the eye picker tool, I'll just pick this color. And to see the color code, I'll just double click on it, and this is the color code 767860. So this is light grayish, yellowish gray color. So this is the color code I have used here. And now let's add some details. So first of all, as you can see, we have little section over here, and we make sure that all the points are little perspective and view. So we have edited that anchor points. And here on the bottom, as you can see, we have added some dark shade. So this is done using the pen tool. So I'll be drawing it out manually. Now I'll select the pen tool, and first of all, let's draw this out border. So as you go over here, you see that it like snaps in the point. So just click over there again, snap it, click. So we'll give some different color for this right now. Let's choose that dark color. I'll just pick this color. In the same way, I'll do the other as well. So I'll just draw out the shapes for the bottom. So click. I'll just go do this for here as well. Click. This is one of the way to create your design. We have seen other techniques in our first part and second part. This is some of the other ways you can create your design. And if you, this technique is used especially when you want a detailed design. You can't depend on options to create some amazing designs. You have to make it manually sometimes to give it some, to create some impactful design like that. And for this shape, we need this shape separate. So what I'll do is I'll just create a outline around it and create a shape like that. And after that, what I'll do is I'll just select this shape, this one, I'll just create a duplicate of it, Command Control C and Command Control F, then select this, and I'll just intersect, maybe, what do you call it? Let's go to Pathfinder, and I'll be clicking on this intersect, and that way, okay, before that, so as you can see, this is a blend object, so we have to convert this into fill object. So I'll just go to object and expand it and click OK. And after that, everything is in strokes. I'll just go to here and unite them to make it one object. And this will take a little bit of time, but once it's done, it becomes very light. And here we go. This object is now single fill color. So we have to ungroup it first. So I'll just select this and ungroup it. And then we'll select individual two shapes and intersect. And you got this piece. Let's see. Okay, and let's see this one. Okay, so we got that. Now I'll arrange it to back. So with the command or control pressed, click the open square bracket to arrange it to back like that. So it's done, and the top bottom shapes are made. Let's add this intersection. So we'll be drawing it out using the pen tool. So I'll just use the pen tool and just go over there, and you can just snap it at the corners like that. So click and click. So here, okay, this one, I'll just make a partition as well over here for A shape. So go there and to the bottom, then around here, and just match it over there. Just finish it. For the R, we'll separate from here. So click, click, and one around, click, click, and here we finish it this way. These are three shapes, and I think this is enough for this design. And I'll just select these three shapes and apply a color. So I'll just apply this color, and what we did is we brightened it up a little bit. So I'll just pick this color, and we have given this color code. Actually, this is the same color as this, but we have used the color slide over here just to make it a little brighter like that. And we applied it over there. And what we need to do next is we need to arrange it to back. So let's use the command control shortcut with the open square bracket like that. And make sure it's just below the outline, not below our black design. So just keep it on the top of this and below the outline like that. And here we go. And now let's do a little more adjustments. As you can see, there are some tweaking needed. So here it's line. We have to make it a little perspective look. So with the selection tool, A is the shortcut, click the point and just drag it up until here like that. Do the same for the rest. So for A as well, I'll just select this and I'll just make sure it snaps over there, and this point snaps over there. I'll go over here, I'll make sure that I think this side is pretty good. Okay, this one. So just go there, just click this one point and click and drag it up till there. And let's see if it's anything is left out, and I think everything is fine. So I just keep it like that. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is to apply that drop shadow. So for that, what I did is we selected this shape, this one, and go to Object, Stylize, Drop Shadow. And here, preview it. Okay, and you can see that drop shadow. You can adjust the if you want to give it a little blurriness, you can increase it over here. But for this design, I want it sharp, and we can adjust the positioning using this. So let's make it little around this much, and this side we will decide how much you want to shift your shadow to the right side. So let's shift it around. As you can see, we have to like this much thickness gap is there, so let's keep it around this much. And for the bottom, this much, and this line and this part, this line and this part, and I think this looks good. I'll click OK. So here is our drop shadow with a design effect. And as you can see over here, there's one more design and it looks really good. What I did over here is it's the same technique, same design, only the color combination is separate. Let me show you how. So I'll just select everything and create a duplicate of it, let's say. And what I'll do is I'll just apply these color to this. So what I'll do is I'll first change the background color. So with the applicator tool, just pick this color, and I'll show you the color code as well so that you can do it with yourself as well. This is the color code, and let's go further. So for the top one, it's a little light green, so I'll just select this top surfaces and let's pick this color, and let's see the color code. This is the color code. And now let's select the shaded one. So what I'll do is I select this, and with the applicator tool, pick this color, this one, light blue color. So this is the color code. You can see the color code over here. This is light bluish tone, and click OK. Now for the bottom part, we have used little dark blue color. So I'll just directly pick it. So what I'll do is I'll just select these. And with the applicator tool, I'll just pick the color from here. And here's the color code. And for this low one, let's apply gradient color for this. So let's apply gradient, then click and drag over here. We'll be using this color, so I'll just copy this color code from here. Command Control C, and for this G, for the top one, we'll change the color to that. So I'll just paste it over here. Command V, enter. And for the bottom one, we'll use this dark color. So let's pick the color code for that as well. So I'll just select this and double click on this, and you got this color code. Copy it over here, then select this and press G for gradient, and double click on this and paste it over here. And this way you can apply gradient to your design just like this. Very simple, very easy. And we can just slide a little bit upward just to make sure the bottom one is a little darker and here brighter, like that. Okay, now let's see what else we can do. So the color is changed, the bottom is changed, and now the only thing that remains over here is this inner shadow. So it's very simple, just select them and pick the color, and the color code is 727834. And for the highlighted shapes, let's select those highlight shapes, this and this. And for the applicator tool, I just pick this color, and this is a little lighter color tone from that dark color. Here's the color code and click OK. So this way you have seen it's the same design, and as you can see, the shadow is a little darker. Let's make it dark. So we'll go to the appearance, and here go to drop shadow, go there, and let's increase the percentage. So let's make it very dark, let's say around 80. Let's check it out. So we can reduce the opacity a little bit more, and let's keep it around 60 and click OK. So here we go. So we have used the same design, and the only difference was the color, you are applying with. So this one is a little darker base, and this one is lighter base. And if you change the color, it gives you different look and effect. So this is how we have created our first design. Now let's go to our second design, and as you can see, the second design is a little darker retro 3D effect, and we'll be creating out this design. So to create this design, we'll be using 3D extrude bevel option to create out this design. So we'll be adding this depth using 3D bevel option. Then for the shades, we'll be using the blending option to create this hard falling shades. And later on, we'll work on with this outlines using the offset option. Then we'll add some shades and all. And for the last design, we'll be using the same technique to create this basic shape with the blending option. And after that, we'll be adding like shades using the patterns. And we'll understand how we can use patterns to give like details to your design. And later on the front as well, we'll use the parallel line patterns, and we'll add some shades like this. So don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.